Hey everybody, today we're going to be taking a quick look at a new feature that's in preview in CockroachDB 22.2, UDFs. As you probably already know, UDFs are user-defined functions that allow you to run code and perform calculations directly within the database, minimizing the number of round trips that your data has to make between the application layer and the database layer. Let's take a quick look at UDFs in CockroachDB. For the purposes of simplicity, let's create a basic function that simply adds two integers together. Let's break down the elements of this function. First, we've got the create statement, and we're defining the name of the function, which is add. Next, we've got the arguments the function takes and their data types. In this case, it'll accept two arguments, both of the integer data type. Then we'll define what the function returns, which in this case will be another integer. Next, we'll define the function's volatility, which relates to whether or not it can impact or mutate data in tables in our database. In the case of this function, it can't, so we've got it tagged as immutable leakproof. Then we'll specify the language the function body is written in. In this release, only SQL is supported. Finally, we've got the function body itself, which in this case is a simple select statement, and then of course we'll close the full create function statement with a semicolon. Now we can run it. And as we can see, the function has been created. To invoke it, again, all we'll need is a simple select statement. And we can see that it's working as expected. This is a simple example, so let's take a look at a real-world UDF in CockroachDB. This one was written by CockroachDB user Saqib Ali, who is the lead analytics engineer at Saks Fifth Avenue. I'll put the GitHub link in the video description so that you can contribute to this if you want, but basically what this does is takes a timestamp value and calculates the number of minutes, hours, or days ago that that value is from the current time. To demonstrate, let's give it a timestamp value, in this case one from quite a while ago. And we can see the expected result is returned. Obviously, the beauty of UDFs is that they can do whatever you want them to. And now that they're available in CockroachDB, it'll make some migrations more straightforward as well. And this is really just the starting point. Unlike some other distributed SQL databases, we're not just taking legacy UDF features and bolting them onto CockroachDB, and thus limiting them to single-node operations. Instead, we're actually building a bigger feature called distributed functions from the ground up. Our vision is that functions, triggers, and stored procedures will be fully distributed so that they can enjoy the same efficiency, availability, and scalability as other features of CockroachDB. UDFs in 22.2 are really just the start, so stay tuned.